Coach, you know, when you look back at last season and everything that you guys went through and the squad that you had, I mean, what are your main takeaways from that team?
Well, you know, I mean, in years to come, people look back and say, you know, Neumann was 5-5 in 2017. They must not have been real good. That's just not true. We had a good football team, and we had a very fun football team. They were fun to coach. They were fun to be around. And I just really enjoyed that season a lot. It's just that the schedule worked out such that we just played some really, really good football teams, and we played them good, you know, played them well, but not well enough to win.
Now, you have got some good players coming back for you, some important key guys coming back. Let's start with Caden Johnson, you know, big two-way player for you. What does he bring to the table that maybe separates him from other players in the area or, you know, even in the state of Nebraska?
Well, I think number one is his attitude. His attitude, you know, he's one of those guys that you read about some other team about what he does in his, you know, what he does in the weight room and what he does on the field, and you think, geez, why don't I get one of those guys? Well, he's one of those guys, you know, and he's a leader. He's a leader by example. I mean, he gets a lot of kids to follow him just because of the way he works. He's the kind of kid that'll come out here in the summertime and get the bags out all by himself and do agility drills and everything all by himself and then come to another workout later in the evening. He's that kind of kid, you know, and he's just one that you just love to have.
Okay, now, I know he's being recruited, you know, by quite a few schools right now. What's kind of the feedback been from a lot of those coaches that have come through to see him?
Well, you know, some of those coaches have gotten here after school, and we've been doing our agility workouts and our winter conditioning stuff, and they just, number one, really like the way he moves for as big as he is, and then, again, like his attitude in here when he's lifting and, you know, watching him lift a little bit. And I think all those things put together, just his whole attitude about how he approaches things and how he does things. And then, you know, and like you said, you can see on the film the kind of type of player he is.
Okay. Now, I guess when you look ahead, you kind of project him, you know, what do you see his body kind of doing? Where do you see him, you know, eventually fitting in college?
Well, I just think he's a prototypical tight end. I mean, excuse me, defensive end, kind of a rush-in type guy. He's just relentless. He's quick enough, and I think he can get quicker. I think he can play at maybe 20 pounds heavier, you know, and play at 265, 270. And I think he's the type of end that a lot of schools are looking for.
Okay. Now, we'll talk about Eli Vedral. Obviously, you know, you know Eli real well. He talked about his hand injury and everything that he went through last year. You know, I guess how did he kind of step up and you know fill that role?
Yeah, he mentioned he wanted to, you know, improve on his passing and that kind of stuff. And last summer, all through the summer, you know, doing our workouts and doing our 7-on-7s and that kind of stuff, I started kind of thinking, wow, Eli's really coming along. His passing is really improving, and he was really, I mean, really looking good. And then he broke the bone in his right hand and before the first game and played every game and speaks to the toughness. Because that, I don't care what you say, that had to hurt taking a snap. And, you know, kind of got to where whenever we did throw the ball, he kind of had to push it a little bit, couldn't grip it and spin it the way he wanted to. And I think by the time the injury healed, he just was kind of in that bad habit of throwing, you know, and so I'm really looking forward to hopefully he gets to go through a whole summer and a whole year injury free, and I really think he's got some potential. The thing about our team last year is every one of our skill people were young guys, and they're all back, and we're really deep in those positions, and that and our linemen are like Caden said, we've had a great winter in the weight room. All our linemen have in there, and so it's going to be exciting, I think, for us.
Okay, now it seems like Eli and Caden are kind of carry themselves as leaders. I mean, is that fair to say those
sure.
two
mm-hmm.
guys that mm-hmm. are kind of lead the way, whether it's on the field or off of it?
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, definitely. And then, you know, we have some other linemen. Sam Kavan is a kid that played for us tight end. He's played tight end, and with the graduation of our lineman the year before, I asked him if he'd consider playing line. He said, "Coach, I'll do anything you want and anything the team needs." And he's, you know, he's a big, sturdy tight end at, you know, 220 or so, and he'll help us in the line. And Cade Welch is back in the line, and Caden. And we got Conrad Sander back at center. So we're really pretty strong there. We got those kind of guys in the offensive and defensive lines that I think are a year older, a year stronger, and a year more mature. I think that's going to be really a factor for us as we progress through the season.
Okay. Now, I know Eli is a multi-sport athlete. Speak to his overall athleticism and kind of some of the things that you can do with a guy like that.
Well, he's much like his brother, you know, in terms of, as he mentioned, he reads our offense real well. We run a lot of reads. We read a lot of different people. And that's another benefit of having Noah down at the university. We've already got scheduled a couple of chalk talk sessions where I can go through and maybe steal a few things from Coach Frost's offense a little bit, you know. So, but Eli's really good at that kind of stuff, at making reads. He's a good, strong runner, powerful runner, and he does a really nice job of what he said he needs to improve on is just his reading the defenses, and that's where I think he knows he needs to work the most, and I think he'll do a good job at that.